Hi, Dr. Saxena here, and as usual, we are going to talk on some common thing which you and me constantly are taking, including I am always, one thing I can always tell you, things which can result in some of the cumulative accumulation of some of the toxins, namely, I can talk about arsenic here, is one thing I want to discuss today. The consumption of rice. There were the sufficient number of studies showing that arsenic has got, it is a safe nothing to worry about what is the content of arsenic in rice you have got, but I can always tell you things are getting back to worse. Arsenic in our findings, whatever has been studied and all that, which is published in something like November 2012, and this is being arsenic in the food was found in very high quantities, and there's something like dressing was done in from white rice, you have got from brown rice, you have got some organic rice, and so what are the things which we need to look into that? Because somewhere I, as a matter of fact, I'm a rice eater, and I don't feel, if I don't eat that kind of rice at least once in a day, I don't feel that my tummy is, we don't have that satisfaction of you had that full meal. So what can be done now? What are the things which I, as a trying to work in this, having worked for so long in this environmental field, trying to work on mental toxicity and all that, what I'm trying to put across is there are sufficient number of reasons available. We believe this arsenic is causing some problem, and this is a cumulative toxicity which comes embedded in the rice consumption is one thing. So there were people who started looking into that. There was one study which came, arsenic in the apple juice was found, and the grape juice, and they said, okay, what is that thing? And but I'm worried about that small cumulative things which really add up over years and all that, which causes some problems. So the tests have found, the test samples, about 200 samples were done. I'm talking about Environmental Protection Agency, which has done this particular stuff, and they had shown more than 200 samples, the arsenic levels in the rice products were quite high, and this is according to the standards what have been we are talking about. It may be at one sample of rice, or you are subjected for consumption on a daily basis, so 7 days a week, 30 days a month, and 365 days a year. If you only are hitting only rice, you are not trying to change your things and all that, I have a suggestion. I'll tell you what to be done now, because I don't think I can go away with rice, and we are very big lovers of biryani here, what kind of rice and all. Any kind of party or any kind of food without rice is incomplete. Apart from that, it's not just the rice I'm going to talk, it's even some vegetables, even water has been contaminated with the rice with arsenic. So you need to be understand this is a big magnitude of kind of stuff, and it was initially arsenic was told that it has to be something like 10 parts per billion is the thing. This level was twice than 5 parts per billion that EPA originally proposed, and I can always tell you the place we live in, this part of India and all that, we had always exceeded, it's sometimes like 30 parts per billion amount of arsenic was isolated in some of the worst samples. So this is this particular thing which we are daily consuming, and there is a cumulative thing what I am trying to put across. Cumulative means a simple thing. I can always take one dose of paracetamol. If I take it on a daily basis for some months, it's not a good thing I'm doing, because okay, it's a permissible level is 500 milligrams per day is permissible, but it doesn't mean I take it for a year or something like that. So this is the backdrop which I want to tell you is this cumulative toxicity is one thing which is really causing a big problem. We are finding issues with cardiovascular diseases, we are finding issues with metabolic diseases, namely diabetes, pre-diabetes and all. Apart from that, we are finding arsenic related to cancer as well. So thing is, what can be done? How we are, we need to look into that. It's reducing arsenic in the foods is feasible, and you need to work it out with in a big level. But what I can always tell you, what you need to learn some methods by which your cooking methodologies can reduce the arsenic in their food. What is that I'm saying? I'm very, very clear about this. I want to, the first thing I'd like to say, tell you is, whenever you are preparing grains, particularly we are talking about rice here, you need to, these grains has to be properly, it has to be, normally what we are doing is, we are pre-soaking the grains in the water. And this was a normal practice. If we can soak the in water for 3 to 4 hours before preparing the food, that's an ideal one. And I'm very sure no one can do that 3 to 4 hours. And still, you people just wash the rice and they just put it on the cooker. And once the cooker lids open, rice is ready with you. So let us see what's happening with this particular methodology. So you're not, you just wash it. You're not soaking the rice overnight or something like that. And after that, whatever rice water you have added, the whole thing you are consuming it as. The way by which you can always reduce this intake of arsenic and these things are, number one, pre-soak the for at least 2 to 3 hours and see that the whole water gets, you throw up that whole water. Then you don't use a pressure cooker at all. Pressure cooker, I know you have got a rice cooker, you have got a so many advances are come, but I want you to go back to that old days, what my grandmother and mother, they used to prepare the rice, and but that time there was no pressure cooker. I'm talking about some 40 years back, no pressure cookers, and it was an open vessel. Open vessel, you are supposed to boil the rice, and once the it gets boiled, you used to check by looking at the rice how much it has become softened and all that. Then that excess water, whatever used to be there, they used to strain up that water, and that water I remember that was used to use for clothing. Used to starch our clothes, because with the cotton, when you look at cotton and all that, when you starch the clothes, it becomes very stiff and all that. So the stiffness of that water, that starch, is because of the starch which has got high levels of sugar. So by throwing out that water, you are reducing the glycemic index of the rice, number one. And apart from that, you whatever, when it gets boiled and all that, some arsenic and some things and all that, they are bound to come into that water, and throwing that water is a very good idea to remove all this toxins and all that, talking about arsenic number one, and reducing the glycemic index of the glycemic index. You should always know glycemic index is one very simple thing. There are some foods like rice, if you take rice, your sugar levels start rising. It's about 60 to 80, something like that. There are low glycemic foods like your vegetables, like your pulses and all that, which doesn't raise the blood sugar to that high levels. So glycemic index is calculated. You have got some fruits which have got high glycemic index, more almost 100. Watermelon is amazing. It's a very sweet thing. So when you are dealing, when we are trying, we try to work on two major metabolic diseases now. One is obesity, another one is diabetes, and of course cancer also. So we tell them not to use this high glycemic index foods, rice or this one. So what exactly I'm trying to do for my kind of rice, because I am a very big every day I need to have that rice, because something like all of us are having the problem because we were used to it. So if a one meal also I don't take rice, I think my tummy is not full and I don't feel that you don't get that satisfaction and all that of a good meal. So what I'm doing differently, I'm telling everyone to see that don't use that cooker. Number one, trying to pre-soak the things, and you can always see that the rice water in the rice, which we call it in our local language as ganji or peesh and all that, that has to be thrown off. Then all these toxins, at least 80 to 90% can be eliminated, and that is a big kind of catch. This will help all of the people who are dealing with this particular problem. In the sense, needless to say, we don't want all this arsenic and all that to accumulate over a period of time, and you always come for detoxification to me every time. I'm not interested in that. I keep telling about this is how we try to work it out. Yes, it is. It's up to people who can always take. There are studies which have shown drinking water also has got a problem. Drinking water also has got high levels of arsenic, and there are some areas we used to think that it was only the West Bengal and Calcutta area which has got high levels of arsenic, but now we see all parts of India. I'm talking about India because I know the length and breadth of the country, and I have seen not just here, in the other parts of the world also. In US, arsenic is found in the rice. Just because we have good testing facilities, we are able to pick it up. Before that, we were never able to pick it up, that particular stuff. So there were a lot of difference of opinion. There is a rice producer in California. He began extensive arsenic testing in this particular stuff, and the USA Rice Federation tour tells the consumers, no, there's no reason to be concerned about arsenic in food. And yes, there's no reason basically, but what that particular 10 parts per billion also, which adds over a period of months to years, that makes a problem. That is the one thing which we are not talking about, one particular thing. You're not eating rice once in a week, or you're not eating rice once in a month. You're taking 26 days a week, 26 days a month. I have seen people eating rice 3 times a day. So this arsenic can enter the soil, this can enter the water, it can enter into rice and all these crops and all that. That's the how we get into problems. So in this segment, I thought, let me work it out, let me show you. This is the way I look at, and how you can always get away with this particular thing. Arsenic in food is a reality, and you need to work it out. And particularly rice, arsenic in rice is absolutely a big thing. And just because we don't have testing facilities, our rice has got a very bad name in US, because it contains arsenic, it contains cadmium to the minuscule amount also, but it is there. So you need to work on how you can get away with that, not getting into some silly chronic diseases. That is my teaching people try how to. I'm not a good teacher, but somewhere people have to understand. You have to start not using that pressure cookers and all that. Try to work on what is simple, and look at this kind of stuffs which will help you out in a big way. Not getting into all chronic disorders and all that. That effectively we can remove that DIS from the disease, and come back to ease. And I think all of us can do that by just following some simple this kind of methods. Thank you.